in the main event. And incidentally, before we get underway with this, this, of course, is wrestling, but next Tuesday night, promoter Pedro Martinez gets into the boxing promotion with one of the first professional boxing cards here in Memorial Auditorium in many a week. Jackie Donnelly, Buffalo's popular lightweight, will be in there against Mickey Driscoll in the main event, and that's next Tuesday night. Now let's get to wrestling. Now, Bill Miller has adapted some new tactics here. Arm takedown, a nice hold by Bill, and a head scissor by Ilio, and it will be broken on the ropes. Should be, but Bill decided to get a toe hold there. Now, look at that. Bill is trying to, I think he's trying to con Ilio into something here. If I may use that word, he's trying to soften him up for something. A hip rollover and a good one. Gee, Ed Miller didn't last too long, did he, against Hombre Montana? Of course, actually, Brother Bill brought about his downfall. And to prevent anything like that happening in this bout, Commissioner Joe Masters has sent Ed Miller back to the dressing room. Both men on the ropes, calls for the break, but they don't break. They get back into the ring and keep going. This may be a choke by Ilio. He has that left arm underneath there. Pete Sacco checks it. Yep, he decides it is. It is a choke. Calls for the break. Ilio breaks, but doesn't stay with it. Cleanly so far, and Ilio DiPaolo using what Pete Sacco termed the illegal hold for the moment. Miller now putting that head of his right into the stomach of Ilio DiPaolo, and that's it hurts. Pressure on the back. Body scissor by DiPaolo. A good one. Ilio has a great pair of legs, despite the fact that as a small child he was afflicted with polio. Hard to believe it now when you see that great body of his. But on occasion, if you ever get him in a still moment, you'll notice that I believe it is his right leg does not quite have the strength of the left one. From the knee down. It's a little smaller than the other leg, but Ilio has certainly overcome that handicap. Draw attention to the illegal use of extra leverage by Bill Miller. There he is doing it again, using the bottom strand of the ring. So far, this is a good battle between a couple of great competitors. Now, Bill Miller has about a 50-pound weight advantage on Ilio DiPaolo, who weighs 245. Bill Miller is at 295. Ilio holding onto that body scissor. But it's loosening. Miller seems to have it loosened up a bit. There it is. He broke it. But Ilio is maneuvering her now into a hole that is not. It is actually a leg Nelson. A Beautiful maneuver by Elio DiPaolo. There you see it. A leg Nelson. Oh, Bill Miller does not like that one. Could be a pin there. We doubt it. That's a choke. Now, Miller, Bill Miller has escaped and is using the trunks underneath. You perhaps can't see it, but he is using the trunks for a little extra leverage in there, trying to get the pin on Elio. Boy, there's a feat of strength. 245 pounds is up in the air right now. Bill Miller, meanwhile, is in the throes of a hammerlock. Miller using the bottom strand of the ring ropes to effect a release here. That hurt. Point here in the corner of the ring. We're at the ring level, of course. Always have to kind of keep our feet ready to move, because you never know when these fellows are going to come tumbling out on your lap or on your table. Here comes Bill. Oh, he's close to us, too.
It's just strong, that's all.
He is strong. That's Bill Miller telling us something that I don't think we had to be told. Strong is the word for Elio DiPaolo. Giving him that arm shiver, forearm smash. Woo! Woo! So far, this has been, to my mind, a magnificent wrestling bout in that the boys haven't really gone too dirty. They haven't gotten into that savage brutality that has marked some of their previous bouts, such as 2 weeks ago. It's been a good wrestling match, but a lot of things can happen before it's over. It's a fall to a finish. There's Elio with that bar arm lock in. Got him again now. Elio is making wonderful use of his legs here. He's trying to get him around where he can pin him, but he isn't able to do it from that position. Oh, man. That'll do a nose job for you. You like to have your nose pushed right into that canvas hard. Now he's just rubbing those in the dirt. literally. This is a hole we haven't seen. Bill, of course, is using that lower strand. Dishing it out tonight. Elio trying to get Pete Sacco to ask Bill Miller if he's had enough. This is a finishing hole in the sense that it is a submission hole. But I doubt very much that Bill Miller is going to give up. Say what you will about the Miller brothers, they're got all the courage in the world. A match like this is somewhat reminiscent of the real old timers who used to go to the mat and stay there for a couple of hours at a time, 6-7 hours sometimes. Fellows like Frank Gotch and Hackenschmidt and the Zabiscos, they'd get on there and get one hold and keep it for 25, 30 minutes. And these fellows aren't doing that, but it is more of that type of wrestling than we are used to seeing. Leo's a Bearcat. Now they're beginning to slug it up. Timer Huey Shannon over there. He moves rather quickly to get out of the way of that 300 pounder. Grueling match. Now Bill Miller going for the tag team rope. Here he goes for it again. He's using it, I believe, on the eyes of Elio to follow. Now the corner turnbuckle and the whole ring shakes. Let's try it again, says Bill. Once more for luck. Bill is rather partial to that corner. Now he's going to try something else, and there goes Ilio out of the ring for the first time. Bill Miller has been out twice. This is Ilio's first trip out. Ilio not getting up, oh, believe. Can't see him. Here he comes. Pete Sacco is in a disqualifying mood tonight, so it would behoove Bill Miller that would take his advice and stay away. Sacco told him to stay in the corner. He launched himself through there that time. He wanted to be sure he was getting back in. Pete Sacco.
what the crowd has been waiting for. Flying drop kick. Here comes Bill Miller. He's caught in the rope. He's caught in there. As you can see, that arm is securely wedged between the top two ropes. Ilio is doing nothing to help. On the far side, Ilio is trying to put the pressure on the ropes. Pete Sacco trying to break it over here. Got him out. Look out, Ilio. He was looking out. He booby-trapped him. Now, Ilio was on his way to a victory much like this a couple of weeks ago when he was disqualified. Let's see here. Bill Miller is a cagey performer. Pete Sacco trapped underneath there. Bill Miller has that right knee on the throat of Ilio DiPaolo. Look at Pete Sacco. He's really mad. Ilio back in there again. The Irish whip. Ooh, boy, that whole ring shook. Now the other. Boy, I'm telling you, that whole ring moves about 2 feet. Bill Miller has his legs over the bottom strap. Boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. These two really dish it out. And Ilio has been doing most of the dishing. Paul Nelson. Guaranteed to make your mouth 3 inches bigger. The punishment and abuse that these two fellas take. Well, the both of them dishing it out all the way through. No let up in this spot. Here comes Big Billy to the turnbuckle. And right over on our table. Well, I knew we had a move. That's a nice looking table. Well, that's what we've been waiting for, or expecting, I should say. Bill is coming back here. There we go. Now we'll just sit here without a table. A table. Here comes Bill Miller. What's he got in his hand here? He grabbed a rug. There's a stick in it. Boy, that's a dirty rug, too. Look at the dust fly. Well, that, I guess, he's on the bottom of the steps. Oh, boy, everything's happening tonight.
Bill Miller landed on that table of ours and bent it into about a U shape. Fortunately, we weren't underneath the table, or we'd have had a new shape. A knee lift by Ilio. Boy, Ilio is really dishing it out. They're both very tired, however. I think Ilio does not have the strength that he couldn't have. Neither does Bill Miller. Their blows don't have the authority that they did as they started out this bout. This is like batting practice at Yankee Stadium. I believe we are getting fairly close to curfew time here, which is 11 o'clock. And unless somebody comes up with something here, this bout may not go to a decision of any kind. He's so caught in there. Bill Miller did it to him. Now look at Pete go at him. He's like a little tiger. I'm surprised that Pete Sacco hasn't disqualified Bill Miller, except that it is the main event, and Pete, in justice to the fans here, would like to see it go all the way. A little massage that Bill Miller doesn't particularly care for. Miller digging at the eyes. Screen, I believe, from your view by Pete Sacco, but he's digging at those eyes.
Can't you disqualify, Sacco?
I'll tell you something, both these boys are very, very tired. They've gone full speed all the way. Hang on, here comes Bill Miller. Boy, he's on our side. We've heard the bell over there. If it is, it's the curfew. It's the 11 o'clock curfew. And Bill Miller has been out on this side of the ring most of the night. That was the curfew bell, which means there will be no decision here. They went all the way to the 11 o'clock curfew, and man, they really dished it out. Danny Weiss now collecting the slips. Here comes Brother Ed Miller. He finally got back in here now. Danny Weiss now giving us the decision.
After 28 minutes and 10 seconds of wrestling, the officials have voted in favor of Ilio Di Paolo, the winner.
They did give a decision to Ilio Di Paolo, and a very popular one with this crowd. We thought with the curfew that there would not be a decision on it, but Ilio Di Paolo was awarded that win. Ed Miller checking on the slips. He wants to get a look what happened to Brother Bill, but it is official that Ilio Di Paolo won the decision. A big victory for Ilio tonight.